of our team, okay? So the team forward. If you're, yeah, we want you to be behind. Okay? Come on, you guys.
Good morning, basket! All right, let's go to the dashboard. So, yesterday, pretty good day, 46,500. Not bad at all. Look at this, we're caught up across the board, right? Right? All right. Speak now or forever, hold your peace. Production mistakes, Lucas?
Nope.
Nothing. Regular mistakes?
Yes.
Nuts? Oh.
All right, yesterday I got an order, I got a call. I typed thin instead of thick, I know, red box, on a distributor order. So they opened it up, they got what I typed.
Thin what? Thin, thick what?
Glue. 2x10?
Sorry, 2x10 glue. 10 ounce.
That's unfortunate.
It's just something just oversolved.
Well, I saw THI, and then I put N instead of CK.
So we're working on
how do we make sure that doesn't happen again?
Alicia needs to be more careful. And
that's a customer problem because we've been getting it.
What?
But if it, we've been having the same. We get different because we get a label thing. Repeat thing.
You mean I sent you the wrong glue?
I can't see whether it's you or not.
There's got to be another name for thin,
right,
other than THI.
Change the language.
Yeah.
It's English. Yeah, but I'm just. My guys go, this isn't thick. They go. Well,
change it to watery.
Talk to Alicia.
Watery.
Talk to Alicia. Yeah. So, tell them to call me.
Yeah. Good idea.
All right. Well.
Watery skill.
That's all right. Austin, what about back orders?
Back orders are still at one.
Still at one. Unfortunately, we got some Kaizen phone that's still on back order.
So put that in perspective, you guys. That's one out of 800 products.
Okay. And missing tools. Todd?
Yes.
Unfortunately, we do have some missing tools.
I found the hammer, but still missing tools.
Oh, you found the hammer. Okay.
Oh, the screwdriver?
Two of them.
Here
out of the drawer.
We used them over here on this system. We were building this.
One of them is in the front office, the building computer.
So we're missing which one, big one or little?
The big one.
I used the slot one to take off all the electrical plugs when I was doing that. Did you find the slot
one? No, that was a different one. These are the blue ones out of the drawer. I found that one.
Okay.
So we're missing those two.
All right, well, keep your eye out.
We need to get these.
For these screwdrivers. If we don't find them, then we need to replace them. All right, that's it for missing tools, right, Don?
Yeah.
All right, tomorrow's morning leader, actually Monday's morning leader, is going to be Daniel.
First time?
Yes!
First time?
Yes.
Oh,
all right, take notes. All right, we're going to go on a raving fans here. We do have a raving fan. Miss Shelley, would you please read this for me?
Sure. Hello, Paul. I wanted to reach out to you and give you a big kudos on your third edition of the 2 Second Lean book. I've read countless lean books in my 15-year journey. However, I've never come across a book like yours. Like you, I started my career behind the bench in millwork company fabricating custom cabinets and fine furniture. Finishing was my expertise and love. Laugh out loud. I really enjoyed the audiobook version with all the off-script moments of truth and how simple you present the methodologies of Lean. I enjoyed it so much that I decided to share a copy of your book with my boss in the hopes that he might get a better picture of what true Lean is. I share all the same passions as you do regarding Lean and how it's the people that make the magic happen in Lean. Every time I present a Lean 101 class, that's the first topic I go over. I believe in lean with people and not lean to people. Best regards, Milo Conopal.
Nice. So, you give us a little background on this guy, Paul? What's the deal?
I don't know. I get 10 of these emails every day, so. All
right.
I don't always forward them on, as you guys know, but I think the other one's even better. Did you get the other one by any chance?
Any comments, Craig?
Because the other one was way better. Didn't I forward another one? It was from Todd from Wood from a wood tape.
Todd from wood tape.
Wood tape. It's not Todd.
Todd Smith, there he is.
Todd Smith. This one is, I gotta be honest with you, when I read this one, I kind of cried. This was the most incredible email that I received yesterday.
Paul.
All right, here we go, Shelly. You're not done yet.
Oh, it's gonna make me cry.
Well, it made me cry. It didn't make you cry.
Right, here we go.
Paul, this is a long overdue note to let you know. To let you and Carl Waddenston know that my YPO/WPO visit to FastCat last October has had a lasting effect on our business. Specifically, we are dedicating time each day to teach the three pillars of Lean using the priorities of safety, quality, simplicity, and speed. Each of our teams now has a daily morning huddle whereby we are performing 3S and dedicating 1 hour of each workday to learning to see waste, fixing what bugs us, and improving flow to serve our customers. We have met some setbacks. However, being able to see and experience your journey provides a great foundation for reminding ourselves that the objective is to grow people and that daily dedication to getting better requires leadership from the top. Please share with your team that they continue to make a difference in our lives by serving as an enthusiastic and genuine examples that which is possible. We continue to follow the American innovator and often reference the videos you have kindly shared with the world on your website. Please share this email and place the following note in your clear gratitude box during your morning meeting with a loud and clear message from our team. Yeah, the team of Formwood Industries is most grateful to the FastCat process engineers and team members. Specifically, your humble, curious, and generous sharing of 2-second lean materials and plant tours have helped us to begin to sustain a path of improving our lives every day.
That makes these tours that much more special. All right, so we're going to go on to wood of the day here, but I want you guys to notice how I set the woods of the day out on the table. Do you notice how there's a bunch on the far end? And
good
not
job.
Stacked
Thank
up
you,
on the
Tyler.
Sides?
Good job.
Median cherry, isn't it?
Huh? What did you think? What do you think, darling?
Oh, no, it's not medium. No, it's a lime.
It's a walnut.
Is it an imperial
walnut? All right, five more seconds.
Yeah, it's an imperial walnut.
Oh, imperial
my
walnut.
Two, one. All right, what do you guys got?
We got it right. Hey!
All right, guys.
Hey! We got it right. Imperial walnut. But with the help of Darla.
Yeah, Darla.
What was that?
Naughty pine.
Got it right. All right.
We had dark red mahogany. We all got it wrong.
Whoa. Oh. What do you think it was?
Imperial walnut.
Oh, no. Heritage cherry. Got it right.
All right.
Oh, I wonder who's guessing that, huh?
I'll take the credit. We got select cherry. We got it.
Nice, nice.
Got it.
All right.
Clear maple. We got it.
Woo! What is that, like 6 out of 7? Sure, let's go with that. Nice job, guys. Get that. All right, so we're going to go up to word of the day here, which is...
Gilead.
Gilead. A group of 1,000, or today's tour. Anyone want to use it in a sentence? Pete, use it in a sentence.
Is it Gilead or Gilead?
Gilead.
Gilead. Can you play it so we can hear it? Can you play it so we can hear it?
I sure can.
Gilead. Gilead.
One more time.
Gilead.
Okay. How are we going to use that now?
I don't know, Pete, what do you got?
This last weekend at the Gorge was a watershed where there were a Gilead.
Yeah. Down at Boulevard Park, there is a Gilead of people on an evening sunset that's beautiful.
Oh, that's a good place to watch the sunset, though.
Also, a period of 1,000 years.
Ooh.
Oh.
Yeah, the river has a Gilead of sand.
The last 1,000 years, no, the last Kiliad, the weather has changed dramatically.
Not in my meeting. Not in my meeting.
He queued it up for me.
All right, who's got number one gratefuls? Let's do that.
I do. I'm grateful for sunny weather, fresh air, friends, and dogs at basket.
Yeah. Here, Heather, I'm going to write the one for Tom. I'm going to write the one for Tom.
There you go. Go ahead and get your megaphone.
Okay. I'm grateful for sunny weather, fresh air, friends, and dogs at Fast Cap.
Yeah, right. The dogs at Fast Cap are the
number two. Oh, you need this?
No. I'm grateful for movies, friends, and that my husband works in the mortgage industry because it's helped us find a house. My husband works in the mortgage industry because it's helped us in buying a house. All
right. Okay.
And I'm just going to put this in real quick. This is for Todd Fowler. This is for Todd Fowler. I put for the Fast Cap team. Great job, you guys.
All right.
I'm grateful. I'm talking loud. For our teamwork here at Fast Cap. And the job that I get to come to every day here at Fast Cap. Yeah. And for my husband.
The nicest guy in the world.
Great kid. Number four.
I said I was thankful for clean water and my family, yes, and Alicia too.
All right, number five. Who's got number five? There he is. All right. I'm grateful for living in a peaceful country. For waking up to another day alive and well. Grateful for weekends, and I'm grateful for my parents.
Yeah, that's nice. That's an important one. Would you rather be grateful for your parents?
Yeah.
You're a genius.
Is he from Azores or what?
I learned the hard way.
Here you go. The older I get, the smarter my old man is.
I said I'm perfect. Grateful for the weather and the fresh air.
Right on. And that brings us to product of the day. Now I'm going to do one of my favorite products of all time. I mean, we can't say we invented the magnet, but the Power Mags. They are awesome. So, Tim, what is your favorite improvement with the Power Mag that you've seen around here?
Oh, so many.
There's so many. Just pick one.
Well, for one, I'm doing one right now. Vlad's got a tool he uses to measure the speed tape. You know, if customers order 50 feet, and he doesn't have a location for it, so I'm putting a magnet, drilling it into the starboard, and a magnet on that tool, so now it's just going to have a location, it's going to click on it perfectly.
Perfect. Whoa. Austin, what about you? What's your favorite magnet improvement?
Over on all the racking, I've got clipboards over there, and I've got everything on a magnet there, and it makes it have a place, it makes everything easy to find, and everything, you don't have to struggle to put it up there.
Okay, for a guess, I'm going to show you my favorite one. Everyone see this? So, there's the pepper. I want to put it away on the sole. It won't go. See that? It won't go. But when it wants to go on the pepper, it goes right on. The salt goes right back.
Wow. And Windex? Is that Windex?
Yeah, the Windex.
Damn you, Greek.
The magnet is in the Windex, and then when you put it back, it snaps right into place.
Even the basket in the center of the table.
The basket in the center of the table. Instead of being just like this all the time, it snaps right into place.
Wow.
Those are all good, but I saw this video a couple days ago, and it blew me away.
Yes, this is it.
Greg here with a lean improvement for the day. I just remodeled my basement. I may want to be getting them all scurvy. Soaps, kind of stuff like that. I even put a little washer on the back of my toothpaste. A little magnets are seriously strong. A little heads up, you want to grind space away. If you do this, you want to grind away the back of the tile so that the magnet is very close to the surface of the face. And be and I put it in place with 2K10, by the way, which we get from FastCat. Critical heads up, you can't let those magnets slap into each other. This one has 3 magnets, and I broke the tile when I was trying to install them because one slapped into the other and it shattered the tile after much grooming and manicuring with a grinder. Also, just a heads up, there are maggots up there. Will blow your mind. So, you got a pacemaker? This is a great and a fun little lean trick that I really glad I took the time to do before setting this time.
Other ones, but just the power mags. I think there's eight.
There's nine.
We just got a
power mag.
Okay, so nine. Counting here's a couple little samples. You guys can take some around, pass them around, play with them a little bit.
Yeah,
don't pinch your fingers.
They're very careful. They're very dangerous.
Yeah, actually. Yeah.
Very dangerous.
Yeah, you, yeah.
So,
yeah.
Awesome.
You guys
they hurt when you get your
we'll
fingers
stick to the
down.
For one of these guys, 3/4, 19 pounds of holding power.
You get two in a pound.
Okay, how many would you pay for two?
Oh, this is going to snap out.
Yeah. I guess 19.
$10.99 for a two-pack. So, $5.50 each. That's not bad. Those are really strong magnets. All right, we're going to move on to improvements now. Let's go with Jane. Everyone knows it.
Well, I took on the grout bins. There get to be so many hanging there that sometimes the hummock card gets mixed up
little
front and they
Jane.
Don't. Sorry.
Don't make me bring this up.
sorry. It's on the grout bins to where when they're hanging and people grab them, the line of the Kanban card to make sure it gets turned in right, they get mixed up. So I put a holder in there to hold the Kanban amount back so it doesn't mix up with what you're grabbing. So. Nice.
And which one of the four criteria does that meet for an improvement?
Probably faster because you're mixing it up.
Okay.
Yeah, I'd say quality.
That.
Well, it's not going to affect the quality though because it's not for the customer.
Less struggle, definitely.
Simpler,
right? Simpler and faster,
yeah.
I'd say.
Okay.
Let's go through the four real quick before we go on to the other improvements. So, what's number one?
Safety.
Okay, number two?
Quality.
Number three?
Simplicity.
And the final?
Fast.
There we go. All right, so let's go with Cameron. What'd you do this morning?
I actually had a few. So, first thing I did was...
A little louder, Cameron.
We go through so many universal inserts at Pocket Tools, so... It was annoying having Tim go grab them because they're so high up in the racks, back and forth, in the middle of something. So I grabbed a couple boxes and they were kind of just floating around and I found a home for them in the back of a pallet. So it's really easy to get to. Also, the ninja tool, which is what I use if I actually mess up a blade and I was sharpening them, it kept sliding everywhere. So I took some traction pad and put it on the bottom so it stays where it's at. I also made labels for everything, black pegs, Kaizen cornered everything, so everything's all labeled and organized over there.
Like four improvements, one nice. Nice.
There you go.
Now, I just want to emphasize, how long have you been here, Cameron?
3 months.
3 months.
And that's
Probation's over?
All right, Kat, what about you? What do you got?
Recently, I changed one of my screens, so it's long. And I want certain things to appear there so that I can see more information. So my Excel spreadsheet where I put my log and all that stuff. So I've been programming it so it automatically pops up there so that I don't have to move things around. So I'm making sure that everything pops up right where I need it.
Nice.
Good example of an improvement in the workplace, in the office up there.
Excellent.
We had some from our guests while I was giving the bathroom tour.
Oh, here we go.
Can't remember who pointed out first, but a couple people pointed out that we are... Our card that's actually on the cleaning buckets are out of date and have some things that need updating. So.
They are. No, that's a good point.
One of the perks of having tours. Fresh eyes.
Fresh eyes. They see everything we don't. All right, Zach, you got an improvement?
Yeah. I put some stickers on the...
A little louder, Zach. Can't hear you over here.
Put
There's
some stickers
guy.
On the machine
He's
over here
on
the calves so I can tell which way to turn the die and move it. Easier.
Okay. Simpler. Nice. We'll do one more. How about you, Robbie? Oh, David, you got one?
Yeah, well, I sent in a picture in the emails, so I was wondering if we could check out that improvement.
So you have to help me which one's first.
Yeah. Let's see, probably. That's the first one right there.
All right.
So this is what it was over at packing. This is the side table, probably the furthest north packing station. And so, yeah, yesterday when I was packing, I was having problems trying to grab, like, the tape when I was going package and just the knives. And it was just kind of inconvenient, and it was kind of in the way on the table. Boxes were hitting it as I was sliding it across the counter. And then the next picture shows my improvement. I built a trough out of a Kaizen box with some Kaizen foam and installed everything there. And then if you go to the very last picture, you can see it's flush with everything, so you can slide boxes from table to table without any interference.
Nice. Cool. Yeah. How long have you been here?
Not quite a month.
Good job.
Wow.
All right, that's awesome. We'll call that good. Let's move on to the FastCat 21 principles. This is a good one. What did Bob Taylor say, Paul?
He said, if you want to be significant in life, that you first take responsibility for yourself, then you start taking responsibility for things, then you start taking responsibility for more people other than yourself, then you start taking responsibility for more things, and more people, and more things.
That's awesome.
That's a little bit more than on here, but yeah. Good job.
I was rehearsing visually exactly what he said to me at lunch that day.
Yeah. Well, yeah, more people, more things. Keep getting more responsibilities. All right, we're gonna go on to the 8 deadly sins of waste. Yelena, you haven't been in the meeting for a while. Let's hear it from you.
Okay, so overproduction, transportation, inventory, defects, overprocess the defects, which is wasted motion. Customers are waiting and we're losing employee potential.
All right. We're just cruising through here. Constitution, we are on the 13th Amendment. And let's take it over to Robbie.
The abolishment of slavery.
Studied up on his amendments. Nice. I'll read it out loud for you guys. Neither slavery nor involuntary servitude shall exist in the United States except as a punishment for crime. Congress has the power to enforce this by legislation.
Robbie, what's the 14th and 15th?
The naturalized citizen and then the right to vote.
For who?
For the naturalized citizens.
Sure. All right, that'll work.
The right to vote will not be limited based on
race,
color, creed,
or previous servitude.
And what amendment did they use that amendment for? Who used that amendment for another amendment to get a constitutional
19th.
Right?
19th.
And who used? What were the name of the two females that were so instrumental in getting the 19th Amendment?
Susan B.
Anthony. Susan B. Anthony.
Why don't you go ahead and take that question?
Elizabeth Stanton.
Yeah, Elizabeth Stanton and Susan B. Anthony.
All right. So is the 13th Amendment part of the Miranda Rights?
Nope. It's not.
The Reconstruction ones.
Yes.
Is that 13, 14, 15?
Yeah. 13, 14,
okay. 15. The Reconstruction. All right, we need the president and the year, Robbie. Do you know for the 13th?
1865.
Yeah.
Thanks, Darla.
You know the president?
Andrew Johnson.
Darla, what's the president?
Is it Andrew Johnson?
It sure is. Nice. All right, we're going to finish up this history lesson we got. Oh, I forgot to show you guys my improvement.
Lay it on.
All right, I'll lay it on you guys.
Darla, what's going on, man?
Finally finished this work of art here.
A little louder. Oh my gosh. Wow. Come on, get out of here. What is this?
This is our bulk and nut categorization. We got everything you could ever want for. Blue is standard. Yellow is metric. The bulk itself is actually glued onto the top with a label. Everything is right behind it. You need to pour 20 by...
Pull one of those bad boys out. Let me see what it looks like. Pull the whole bin out.
Okay. Look at this. Easily able to see how many of it... How many is in there?
Oh my gosh, this is like crazy.
On this as well.
And we just use our Kaizen boxes with the tabs. You glued everything on there.
Oh
But then what happens if you can't reach in one of these little spots? What
well,
do you
that
do then?
That does happen awesome. And we got the 11th finger here. It's magnetic. All you need to do, shove it in there, grab however many you need, the rest, go right back in.
Oh, get out of here.
I'll tell you what, Paul, this is giving me a reincarnation.
Oh, I can't see it on camera, man. That's, at least something, right? I don't know if I can say that, but you can say it.
I'm still here. Awesome. You get fired. You got two left.
Look at how much space we took out.
Because you 3S'd everything.
We 3S'd everything. We have
everything.
That was
so
all
much
full
junk.
Before.
Wow. Well, as always, Tyler, you did an awesome job. So Tyler, and we're not even going to edit this.
Oh, man, that's me, right there.
Yeah, right.
Man, it's all about me today. We got one more here. You know, on the same note there, this is a byproduct.
So this is our reorganized bolt area. You can see everything's got standardized labels now. All the bolts are a lot more easily accessible. It just looks a lot better. Another benefit is it's freed up a ton of space on the other side that used to be full. So now we can stay fresh and rested back here. And it's
don't you have to leave work now?
Oh my God!
I need that video.
That's a good still of it.
You posted on YouTube? Did you post?
It's on YouTube. Oh, yeah. Well, no, we'll do that.
I need that video. Make sure
that is hysterical. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and finish this up real quick. It's just got a couple minutes left. This is Xylem Design.
Greg? Yeah,
we'll take your time. You don't need to suck up the people. So we're watching Greg's video that he showed us last night because it's so incredible. And people are
but
the,
you the button neck because you guys haven't seen the rest of it.
Not the rest of it.
Got it.
That's how far we are.
Pretty much it. He's a sharp dresser, by the way, in case you need to know.
Like this.
Right. Almost don't want to be there because
the table saw.
Because it was hard. It's a hard work.
Yeah, it's hard work physically and mentally, right?
Mentally too. So
yeah,
if you start training people and all, you only have 2 to 3 hours max. Every time you tell them to be on the saw, or because you know,
right?
They like no problem. Because
they
would make a schedule.
Right.
We decide to bring the people who's gonna be on the saw, the sawyers, to make their own schedule.
Oh really? So they work together as a
yes.
team to create their
yes.
schedule.
So like if all the sawyers are like on the same page because they know when is the time to go into the saw.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody's on the same page. You know, it's like I'm done with my. It's not like I'm done with my chef now. I don't know whose turn is. Is the guy on the foreman's his job is to make the schedule and he's gonna deal with that.
He hands the baton to the next guy.
Yeah, that was like all those guys. They're like on the same page. And they know when they need to go to the saw.
So they worked on this together.
They worked together
to make
because
it.
Window was
real teamwork.
Window was a problem, so
right.
It was hard to say, hey, now it's your turn. So we decide how we can make that better.
Yeah. So you did it together as a group.
Yes.
So you got the buy-in.
Yeah. But really, we are a team. We work as a team, not like it's my job. It's not my job. It's we. Mm-hmm. You ask for help, you're never gonna say, oh, that's not my job.
Yeah.
That's not allowed to say that I'm a shop. You know, when people start from the beginning, even the new guys, I said, we're not allowed to say that's not my job because
yeah.
that's not how we work here.
Right.
You know, we all work in a group, you know, it's like in a team, you know, you need some help, no problem.
Cool. Well, thank you.
That's the main thing that I really like. You know, we are a team, you know, everybody's on the same page.
Right on.
Awesome.
Andrea, what's something you got out of that?
I was actually just thinking about it. Is like you said, you know, you work as a team, and here, like, if someone comes and asks a question about, say, like, hey, I need to make this, or I need help doing it, I'd be like, you know, I might not know how, or I might not know, like, I can't actually help you, but I might know who can and put you in the right direction or help them go past that person and make sure they do get it done so they're not just kind of struggling around trying to figure out who can help them with it. So we definitely work as a team here and try and help each other get it done, whether you're the right person for that job originally when they come and ask or not.
What about you, Thomas? Did you get anything from that one?
Talking a lot of similarities.
Yeah. All right, we'll go ahead.
Hey, Tyler, I have a comment.
What do you got?
It reminds me of the Orange Bin Project. There were a lot of us involved. We all had ideas. We disagreed. We agreed. But in the end of the, at the end of the day, it looks great. It was finished.
Paul, you want to tell about that wall a little bit?
Yeah, so... You know, I'm kind of crazy. That wall over there, that whole orange wall over there, that used to be a whole bunch of racks that we had, and it really bothered me visually. It just didn't look right. And we've just switched over to the new orange bin system throughout our facility. We're implementing it. And yesterday I decided I wanted to tear up that entire area the day before you guys were all coming, or the day you guys were coming on top of everything else we were doing. So we ripped out everything and put up that entire wall in about 5.5 hours. We had people from every department helping, working. It was the most magical thing I've ever seen, that much work done so quickly.
It was crazy. It was
Paul, like, but your team has a problem with it.
What?
The stuff on the floor.
Why, what's your problem?
Well, the totes are not on wheels. The paper towels are on the floor. You said nothing on the floor.
Anything well, on? Let's take, for instance, Ed, the pallets are on the floor, aren't they?
Employees' totes are on the floor, and your paper towels.
Yeah, we have enough room to get them up.
Yeah, but let's just go through it. What is the problem with that, though, in reality? What I don't want is, what I try to get at is, when we're around a machine or a piece of equipment or in the office, we don't want stuff sitting on the floor. We want it on a cart so we can move it around and manipulate it. But this is not stuff that we need to manipulate necessarily. It's part of a system. So to me, it doesn't really apply.
All of us were all discussing it.
Right, but what is the problem? Just so I'm just curious.
Off the floor.
No, the cubby. Well, the cubbies, the cubby, the storage stuff, the personal storage stuff. Having them on the floor with the dogs running around, they might get nibbled on whatever's in there.
So Paul, the question for me is, what does getting it up off the floor? What value does that add? Does it add value to get it up off the floor?
I think it does. I think it does for the personal things, because your personal things aren't getting harassed by the dogs and/or.
Yeah, but do the dogs really? My take is, so this, you guys have seen how we really work. Do the dogs really harass? I don't think the dogs harass.
Well, can
I
ask? People who are keeping their lunchboxes.
You can't. You know, but those are not for food. Okay. Those are not for food. Those are not for food. Okay, you guys. Food's for the kitchen. Those are for your personal items: purses, jackets, hats, things like that. Well, what do you, so that would be the problem. So the cleaning would be the problem.
Right. Good point.
Well, all you would need to do is create a board on wheels and set them on the board.
You want to roll it all out.
Yeah, small board.
That's a possibility. All
right, well, let's think about this. I'm going to bring this back on track here. And start stretching. Found this Try and figure it out. How many you need?
comfortable with you here.
And to the left.
Yeah.
All right, now roll your back up slowly. All right, grab an ankle. Stretch that quad out.
Stand down, I'll put the weight of the world on you. You know why I can't be quite as funny.
All right, I think I need to work on questions. I feel like you guys let me off a little easy on that one.
Agreed. You killed it.
Agreed. But thank you.
Phenomenal job. Okay, so what's going on?
Yeah. We're working. We've got a lot done this morning already.
So everything's good. Production's fine?
Yeah.
Okay, so normally what we do right now is we allocate people where they need to go, depending upon the demand that's current in the company. And right now we're okay, so everyone just go to their normal area.
We'll start doing the container right now.
Okay.
And start staging over by the gate, so if I can get four people over there.
Okay, very good. And then the tour, everyone upstairs real quick. We're going to do a breakout session, okay? If you have to go to the bathroom, do it now, and let's go. All right, thank you. Great job.
Yeah, Tyler, listen, let me ask you a question. You're turned around, you give yourself a score?
What?
You give yourself a score first?
No.
Oh, how does it work then? How do you know the guy was standing here?
Oh, yeah, yeah, no, you hand the keyboard off.
And you're looking, okay, good, good. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Awesome.